الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وصحابته الكرام الميامين، وخلفائه الراشدين المهديين من بعده أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم بفضلك يا أكرم الأكرمين. وبعد، to precede, the brother and sister, first of all my advice, I advise myself and you brother and sister to gain a taqwa, the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to gain as much as you can by doing the righteous deeds, by following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we mentioned in a few weeks ago the meaning of istiqamah, to uphold and upright the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal. And from the best of the istiqamah, from the best following the religion, to fill your heart with the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, correcting and clean our heart from all the illness wal'iyadu billah, from the bad disease, from the hatred which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hate and doesn't like, and following the loving of Allah and loving His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the religion of Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a great hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, whoever possesses the following three qualities will taste the sweetness of Iman and sweetness of faith. Number one, the one to whom Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam dearer than anything else. So the number one, to love Allah Azza wa Jal and to like Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger more than anything else. So you have to feed your heart by loving Allah Azza wa Jal, by loving His Messenger, by following His religion, following His command, to obey Allah and to obey His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is which is compulsory upon every slave from this nation, from this ummah, to love Allah Azza wa Jal more than anything else. And how we love Allah? By reading and having knowledge about Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in His book and His and in the sunnah of the book in the, His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by knowing His great and glory and His names and attributes subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the blessing which is He surrounds us. So by remembering His blessing, we have to and we should give Him the priority of our love of our heart, and by loving His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah said in a great verse, قُلْ إِن كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنَ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and it challenges us, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if your fathers, number one, your sons, your brothers, your wives, your relatives, wealth which you have obtained, commerce wherein you are, wherein fear decline, and dwellings with which you are pleased, are more beloved to you These all these things around eight or nine things Allah say. If these are more beloved to you than Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and jihad in His cause, then what's the result? Then wait until Allah executes His command, and Allah does not guide the disobedient people, wal'iyadu billah. So look at this verse in Surah Tawbah. Allah said clearly, and blame us. Be careful if you take these things and will be, and it could be more beloved in your heart than Allah and His Messenger and His commands. Then you are nothing. You are disobedient. You are among the people of fusq and fasiqeen. So be careful. We have to watch and look deeply in our heart. Who has more beloved in my heart? Is it Allah and His Messenger and His command, or something else which is disallowed at all, wal'iyadu billah? So we have to clean our heart from anything which could desiring our hearts and our loving and misguide our beloved to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We back to the hadith. So Allah subhanahu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in second qualities, and who loves a person, his brother in Islam, and he loves him only for Allah's sake. For Allah's sake and for none else. If you love your brother in Islam, but you don't love him for the sake of Allah, you don't love him because he's obedient, his ta'ah, his righteous deeds, he's good in religion, and you love him for something else, will not be accepted at all. You have to love him because he is following the religion, following the obedience of Allah and His Messenger, because he's good in command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the reason which is make and gain the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah said, أَيْنَ الْمُتَحَبِّينَ فِيهِ. Where is the people, where is the believers who have mutual love for my sake? أَيْنَ الْمُتَزَاوِلِينَ فِيهِ. Where is the brothers who are visits each other for sake of Allah? Where is the أَيْنَ الْمُتَبَادِلِينَ فِيهِ. Where is the brothers in Islam who are spent in each other for His sake? الْيَوْمَ أُضِلِّهُمْ. Today, I'm sheltering them, my shade. Where is there's no shade except my shade? This is what Allah said in the day of judgment. This is what you will gain if you do so. This is the great reward ever. If you love your brother for the sake of Allah, or you spend in him when he's in need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you all of this, or when you visit him for the sake of Allah. The Prophet sallam said, one brother went out from his town to visit his brother in other town just for sake of Allah. So Allah sent him an angel. So this angel came to him and he asked him, where are you going? He said, I'm going to visit my brother in Islam just for sake of Allah. He said, just for that? He said, just for that. He said, by the way, I would like to tell you that I am an angel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent me to tell you that is Allah loves you for visiting your brother for his sake from town to town. So this is the reward. This is the aim. This is how to be sincere and watch our doing and watch our doing even of our limbs or our doing of our heart. What's our intention? Allah, most of the time He look at our intention. What's your aim behind your deeds? What's your point What do you like from your deeds? You need, you would like to gain, the reward of Allah or something else which shown off wal iyadu billah. And at the end of hadith, the three qualities under number three, who will taste the sweetness of Iman as we taste the sweets of the food or of drink, the Muslim should taste this sweet of Iman or sweet of faith. So the Rasulullah said number three, who hates to revert to disbelief, kufr wal iyadu billah, after Allah has brought and saved him out from it, as he hates to be thrown in the fire. So we should like this religion. We should follow this religion. We should sacrifice for this religion. We should accept everything for our religion. And we should teach this for our children and families and wives and relatives. That's, this is our religion. This is our capital. This is our asset. Nothing better than our religion. For me and for you, brother and sister, we should give a priority for our religion. And we should hate to be go out from your religion, to back to the disbelief and kufr, more than to hate to be thrown in the fire, wal-iyadu billah. And that's why the Prophet said, the awthaq ala al-iman, the trustworthy in the iman and faith, to love for sake of Allah and to dislike for sake of Allah and to give for sake of Allah and to uphold or withhold for sake of Allah. This is the highest level of Iman. So everything you do it for sake of Allah. As Ibrahim said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِيَ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Ibrahim alayhi salam, our father, said, say, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي, my prayer and my dua, my supplicated dua, and my namaz and my prayer, وَنُسُكِي, the nusuk which I slaughter and sacrifice for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَحْيَايَ, all of my life, وَمَمَاتِي, and my death for sake of Allah. Everything, make it an aim, behind it is to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleased by following the sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all. As'al Allah bimanni wa karami an yahdiyana sawa as-sabeel wa an yaghfir lana wa lakum wa an yu'inana ala dhikrih wa shukrih wa husni ibadatih wa an yamla qulubana bimahabbatih wa mahabbati rasulih وأن يحشرنا معهم يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.